Welcome back. Today we are going to learn physical properties of metals and non-metals. First one, physical state. Most of the metals are solid at room temperature. Mercury is the only metal known to occur in liquid state in nature. No metal exists in gaseous state. Non-metals are generally solids or gases. Non-metals like sulfur, phosphorus, carbon are solids, while hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen are gases. Bromine is the only non-metal which exists as liquid at room temperature. Next one, malleability and brittleness. For understanding this, we have to do one activity before. For that, we have to take small iron nail, a cold piece, a piece of thick aluminium wire and a pencil lead. Beat the iron nail with a hammer. Try to hit it hard. And repeat the experiment or activity with aluminium wire, cold piece and pencil lead also. What do you observe? You find that iron gets flattened due to hammering and turns into thin sheet without breaking. Similarly, the piece of aluminium metal turns into a thin aluminium sheet without breaking. However, the cold piece and pencil lead break into small pieces and then form powder when beaten with a hammer. You might be familiar with the silver foil used for decorating sweets. You must also be familiar with the aluminium foil used for wrapping food. The property of metals by which they can be beaten into thin sheets is called malleability. This is a characteristic property of metal. That is, most of the metals are malleable. Gold, silver, aluminium and copper are highly malleable metals. Because of this property of metals, they are very useful to us. For example, aluminium foil are used widely for safe packing of foodstuffs, medicine, chocolates, etc. However, zinc metals break into pieces on hammering. So zinc is brittle in nature. Non-metals are non-malleable, as they cannot be beaten into thin sheets on hammering, rather than that they break up into small pieces. The property due to which non-metals break up into pieces on hammering is called brittleness. Non-metals are generally brittle. For example, sulfur and coal break up into small pieces on hammering. But some non-metals such as hydrogen and oxygen in gaseous state and bromine in liquid state do not show the property of brittleness. Next one, ductility. Most of the metals can be drawn into thin wires. The property which allows the metals to be drawn into wire is called ductility. Gold and silver are the best ductile metals. Copper, aluminium, iron and magnesium metals can be easily drawn into thin wires. So they are very ductile. The wires inside the electric cables are mostly made of copper metal. Non-metals are not ductile. When stressed, non-metals like sulfur and phosphorus break into pieces and do not form wires. Next property is lustre. Most of the metals are lustrous. That is, they have a shiny surface. This property is called metallic lustre. The shiny surface of metals makes them good reflectors of light. Because of their metallic luster, gold, silver and platinum metals are used for making jewelry and decorative articles. The glass mirrors have thin coating of a metal like silver or aluminium at their back, which acts as a reflector of light. Non-metals do not have shiny appearance like metals. They are dull in appearance. However, iodine and graphite show some luster. Next property, conductors of heat. Metals are good conductors of heat, whereas non-metals are poor conductors of heat. For example, silver is the best conductor of heat, followed by copper. Aluminium and iron are also good conductors of heat. For this reason, metals like aluminium, iron and copper are used for making utensils and water boilers. Non-metals are poor conductors of heat. Diamond is the only non-metal which is a good conductor of heat. Next property, hardness. Metals are generally hard. For example, iron metal is very hard and strong. So, iron metal is used in the construction of bridges, railway lines, machines, etc. However, sodium and potassium are soft metals and can be easily cut with a knife. Non-metals are not hard or strong. They easily break when a large weight is put on them. Only diamond is the hardest naturally occurring substance. Next property, conductors of electricity. All metals are good conductors of electricity. Silver metal is the best conductor of electricity. Copper wires are used in household electric wiring and aluminium wires are used in electric cables because copper and aluminium are good conductors of electricity. Non-metals are poor conductors of electricity. For example, sulfur and phosphorus are non-metals and they do not conduct electricity. However, graphite is the non-metal which is a very good conductor of electricity. We can do one activity to show that metals are good conductors of electricity and non-metals are poor conductors of electricity. For that we need an electric cell, an electric bulb, a key, connecting wires, copper, aluminium, an iron nail, coal and sulfur. Make an electric tester by connecting a cell, an electric bulb, a key and connecting wire to test whether the electricity can pass through an object or not. Connect an iron nail in the circuit as shown in the figure. Repeat the activity with copper, aluminium, coal and sulfur. You observe that the electric bulb glows when an iron nail is connected with the circuit. The electric bulb also glows in the case of materials made of aluminium and copper. The electric bulb does not glow when coal is connected with the circuit. Similarly, the bulb does not glow in the case of sulfur also. You can conclude that metals like iron, copper and aluminium are good conductors of electricity, whereas non-metals like coal and sulfur are poor conductors of electricity. Next property is sonority. Have you ever noticed the difference in sound on dropping iron sheet, a metal coin and a piece of coal on the floor? Do you notice any difference in the sound produced? Have you seen wooden bells in temple? No. The things made of metal produces a ringing sound when struck hard. Suppose you have two boxes similar in appearances, one made of wood and other made of metal. Can you tell which box is made of metal by striking both of the boxes? Since metal produces ringing sounds, they are said to be sonorous. The property of producing a ringing sound by a metal when it strikes with a hard material is called sonority. Thus, metals are sonorous. For this reason, metals are used for making bells and metal wires are used in musical instruments. Non-metals do not make a ringing sound when we strike them. Thus, non-metals are non-sonorous. These are the properties of metals and non-metals. Now we can conclude that metals are solid at room temperature. Mercury is the only metal which is found in liquid state, whereas non-metals are generally solid or gaseous. Bromine is the only non-metal which exists in liquid state. Metals are malleable and ductile, except zinc which is brittle. Non-metals are neither malleable nor ductile. They are brittle in solid form. Metals are lustrous. Non-metals are non-lustrous. Metals are good conductors of heat, except bismuth, which is a poor conductor of heat, whereas non-metals are poor conductors of heat. Metals are generally hard, and exceptions are sodium and potassium, which are soft. Non-metals are quite soft, except for diamond, which is the hardest substance in the nature. All metals are good conductors of electricity, whereas non-metals are poor conductors of electricity. Exception is graphite, which is a good conductor of electricity. Metals are sonorous, whereas non-metals are non-sonorous. Hope you understand everything. Thank you for watching.